The state government has started trials of technology designed to tell public transport users how busy trains, trams and buses will be. It's hoping to avoid overcrowding and congestion on the roads when regular travel starts to resume. Andrew Lund reports.
Finding a seat on the train has never been easier. Patronage is down 90%. But as students prepare to return to school, the Transport Minister is reassuring parents the system is safe.
It's the cleanest it's ever been and the most secure it's ever been.
To help reduce the risks of crowding, the government started trials of technology that will use a combination of Mikey data and sensors to tell passengers how busy their service will be.
What we're really interested in getting as granular as possible down to things like the station, the platform, and even eventually maybe the specific carriage. How busy is that, and should I join this carriage or move to the next one down the train?
We do want to avoid having everyone go back into their cars because we want a future with less congestion and better air quality.
Transport planners are also putting the finishing touches on a new train timetable, which is expected to add more services across much of the network by the end of the year, giving passengers even more room to spread out. For those who do want to drive, the government will spend $26.8 million to restart licence testing when Melbourne takes the next step out of restrictions.
We are going to be getting Victorians back on the road.
Temporary licence testing sites will be set up at Coolaroo, Cranbourne, Mulgrave, Ringwood, Essendon Fields and South Morang, while learner permit testing will be shifted online from early next year.
We've been calling for 7 months for online testing for learners, and today they say it'll be next year.
To help deal with the backlog, Vic Roads plans to employ another 180 testing officers. Andrew Lund, Nine News.